Coming up on this edition of Rock 11 Now, Rockville proves its commitment to health, welfare, and safety and equality of its LGBT community. We'll tell you how. Plus, Ready and Rockville give a financial boost to a local business with its first business expansion fund grant. All this and much more on this November edition of Rock 11 Now. Let's get into it. We begin with Rockville's impressive score on this year's Human Rights Campaign Municipal Equality Index scorecard. Rockville received a score of 98 out of 100, making the city second in the state for lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender support and inclusivity. Commitment to health, welfare, safety, and equality of Rockville's LGBT community is one of the mayor and council's priority initiatives. The number of older lesbian, gay, bisexual, and/or transgender adults continues to grow, and Rockville realizes that aging as an LGBT adult can come with some challenges. That's why the Rockville Senior Center and PFLAG held a LGBT Aging in History seminar to talk about education, advocacy, and support.
Those older adults are coming into their old age with that whole experience and sometimes afraid to be out as they start to need formal services like nursing homes, like senior centers, like home care. And so it's so important to educate the community and also fellow older adults and the older adults who are LGBT themselves so that that disadvantage doesn't follow them into old age.
PFLAG is the nation's largest family and ally organization for the LGBT community. For more information on the group, head to pflagmd.org.
Rockville Seniors Incorporated was chartered in 1980 to financially support the Rockville Senior Center. Traditionally, RSI donates $20,000 a year to support services at the center. And this year, that money is going towards the renovation of the Carnation Room.
This was an old school building. The Carnation Room was the old gymnasium. It still looks like the all-purpose room, the old gymnasium. And we decided as a group 2 years ago that we wanted our $20,000 to go for something that was real, earmarking our funding to something that people would see was an important thing to do. So our first start was, of course, the Carnation Room.
The renovations include new curtains for the stage and new paint on the walls, as well as a new floor. But what about those chairs?
The chairs that are there now, first of all, they don't match the room anymore. And we decided to start a buy a chair campaign because chairs are expensive. And we figured we were not going to get a good, solid chair that would support a senior, especially some of our older seniors, because you're looking at five generations of seniors in this facility. It cost around $250 a piece. So we started putting jars up to collect pennies. We have one on the counter. And, you know, whatever anybody can do helps. We've got the thermometer now, and this will show from beginning to end how we're doing. And right now we have 10 chairs, and that's important.
For more information on Senior Center programs and how to become a member, head to rockvillemd.gov/seniorcenter.
The City of Rockville and Rockville Economic Development Incorporated, or READY, gives out its first business expansion fund grant to KNG Health Consulting. The grant supports existing Rockville businesses that strengthen the local economy by expanding their operations and generating jobs. And that's exactly what KNG Health Consulting will be doing with this money, as they plan on expanding their existing space and even hiring new employees.
Wouldn't have been possible without the support of mayor and council, so we're happy for the financial support that they've given this program and look forward to continued support as we show success with the growth of these companies.
We're excited to continue growing in Rockville, and we're excited that the city is willing to invest in our growth because that enables us to employ more people, to have a better impact, have a greater impact on the local economy.
For more information about READY, head over to rockvillready.org.
Members of the Rockville Volunteer Fire Department gathered at City Hall recently to show their gratitude for the city's support in the purchase of a new Advanced Life Support, or ALS, chase car. The new car supplements existing ALS service by making it more versatile, and it makes Rockville one of the first departments in the county to deploy a new service model, which places paramedics on rapid response vehicles.
It benefits the community in many ways. First off, it provides a greater, quicker advanced life support response. So we would respond with an ambulance to any call, and if they need a paramedic, the paramedic goes. If they don't need a paramedic, then the paramedic stays in service.
This unit will bring the paramedics EMT equipment without the cot. It's a smaller unit, it's faster, it fits into more places, and what we do is instead of having two paramedics on a transport unit or an ambulance, we put one paramedic on this chase car and we can have one paramedic in an ambulance or on a fire engine. So if there's two calls, we can send a paramedic to each call.
The department has a long tradition of serving Rockville and considers its partnership with the city essential in providing the best and most efficient response to its citizens. The mayor and council included a $57,000 grant in the fiscal year 2016 budget to support the purchase of the car, a 2016 Chevy Tahoe known as ALS 703.
The importance here is that we could not have done it without the city. So it was up to the volunteers and partnership with the city to come up with the funding.
If you'd like to get involved and become part of an organization with over 200 members and four stations, here's what you need to do.
We are always looking for new members. We want to perpetuate ourselves for another 95 years. So they can go to our website, rvfd.org. All training is free. And we ask at a minimum of 12 hours a week from anybody that wants to volunteer. So generally it's one night a week.
Find out more about volunteering and the new car at rvfd.org. For Rockville 11, I'm Tony Playa.
Learning about the election process. That's what Brownie Troop 3767 is doing as they hosted last month's Maryland Women and Girls Legislative Tea. It was a part of their Election Connection Patch program, which helps the girls learn about the election process, history on voting, and empower the girls to encourage adults to vote.
Brownie Troop 3767 is working on their Election Connection Patch. And as part of that patch program, there was an opportunity to do an interview of a local elected official. And our girls decided, instead of interviewing one elected official, they wanted to try to interview a lot of them. And so we decided to host the Maryland Women and Girls Legislative Tea. And I think we had a really successful turnout.
It's really important to me to try to be a role model for younger women and for girls as they start to think about their career paths and what doors are open to them. I think things have changed a lot in my lifetime and even before that. And they shouldn't see any limits in their futures in terms of what they can do and what they can accomplish in their communities.
As our future leaders, we wanted to share our experiences with them, our ups and our downs, and what we have to go through to get elected and the processes that we have to go through to get what we want into law and how we make a difference for the people that we represent.
And I just think it's really important for the girls to understand that young women are able to engage in their communities, change their communities, and hopefully one day take on these leadership roles that these women that they got to meet today were already in.
Still to come, local volunteers working to keep area streams clean. Find out how you can help too. And you heard about why the chicken crossed the road. But a recent stormwater management project has city engineers trying to answer that same question, but for a different animal. That story is next.
Grabbing some takeout in downtown Rockville? Maybe running some errands? You can now use one of eight new and free 15-minute pickup parking spots recently installed in Town Center. There are four along Regal Row and two each on Maryland Avenue and Gibb Street. In addition to eight free spaces, there are several portable signs downtown to help point you towards more convenient locations to park around Regal Row. Head to rockvillereports.com and search pickup parking for maps and locations.
Welcome back to Rock 11 Now. Why not join a team to help clean a stream? Trash and other pollutants are clogging up our watersheds. So that's why Rockville's Environmental and Sustainability Department developed the Adopt a Stream program. And some volunteers joined the program and took up the task to help clean streams in the Maryville community.
If trash is not disposed of properly or recyclables aren't disposed of properly, they can blow into streams, they can get washed into streams on rain events, or they could go into our storm drains, which flow directly to our streams.
I've been doing this since 2008 and have been attending most of the stream cleanups since then. We went from one a year to two a year, and so you can really tell the difference because In the past, when we would only come out once a year, there was a lot more trash to pick up. So this year, there's not too much. We haven't had any really large storm events recently. So that's good. That's when you really see a lot. I enjoy doing this. It's a local community event. It's good to see the kids come out. They really enjoy getting out in the stream and getting wet. Of course, the one in the spring is a little warmer, so they jump in feet first. It's nice to see the kids out here volunteering and doing that. And I get a kick out of coming out here as well.
Students who need to get student service learning hours can come and they receive hours for the number of hours that they participate in the activity.
Gotcha. In fact, you can even adopt your own stream. This stream here, Maryvale Stream, was adopted by the Rockville Environment Commission. But anyone who wants to put a team together can adopt any stream within the city limits and make a commitment to clean up at least once, maybe twice a year. Very easy to do. The city supplies all the supplies, the trash bags, the gloves, all the paperwork. They come later and pick up the trash bags after it's complete. And it's something that local communities can do in their own backyard to get more involved.
People should really get involved in their community. Volunteering is a great way to do that. It's a great way to meet new people and make a difference.
To find out more about the Adopt a Stream program, head to rockvillemd.gov and search Adopt a Stream.
In August, we featured a story here on Rockville 11 about the stormwater management project at Watkins Pond, a project that benefits the environment by effectively treating stormwater runoff. But with all the activity, certain residents felt the need to relocate.
We were not anticipating, however, when they left, for them to try to come up over this roadway that you see behind us in order to get to other water sources. We were actually anticipating them going over the other side and going into the stream.
A decision that was based on natural instincts, but proved to be costly.
In essence, unfortunately, some of the turtles were run over, and we got a call from concerned residents, we're so happy they called, that said, we're having a turtle issue out here. So what we ended up doing as city staff is first and foremost trying to get the word out on social media that this was happening, so to ask community members to slow down over here on this road and the road surrounding our project because the turtles were actively migrating. And if anybody's seen a turtle in the wild, they know they don't move so quickly, right? Our storybooks are correct, mm-hmm. One. And then two, we put up these turtle crossing warning signs in the back here to really try to reinforce that message of slowing down and being thoughtful about the wildlife that congregate in these ponds.
The city then went the extra mile by reaching out to the experts, a nonprofit organization that specializes in turtle relocation.
The Mid-Atlantic Turtle and Tortoise Society. So we tried to get them to come on location out to the site, which they did, to try to find any additional turtles that might still be in the pond and actively relocate them in a safe way.
In the future, the city will be working closely with the nonprofit to have a more controlled migration.
And for every ongoing project we have in the future, we're going to be thoughtful about turtle relocation before the project and bring them in as expert consultants to help us do that.
To learn more about the Mid-Atlantic Turtle and Tortoise Society, go to matts-turtles.org. And for more information on the city's environmental program, go to rockvillemd.gov/environment. For Rock 11 Now, I'm Tony Playa.
Rockville teamed up with the Montgomery County branch of the U.S. Green Building Council and the Montgomery County Department of Environmental Protection to create an energy experience for area kids at Lincoln Park.
Well, I'd have to say this was a really great event and a great opportunity for kids to learn about energy efficiency and see energy in motion. I think it was a success overall, and we hope to do more of these events throughout not just Rockville, but the entire county of Montgomery.
Find out more energy resources at rockvillemd.gov/energy-efficiency. Fall is here, and that means falling leaves. Crews with the Department of Public Works have begun leaf collection. Here's some do's and don'ts when it comes to preparing your leaves for pickup. Do place leaves at the curb by 6 a.m. on collection dates. Remember, sticks and all other objects must be removed from the leaf piles. Don't pile leaves where vehicles are parked. This can be a hazard because car exhaust can ignite dry leaves. Do avoid street parking near leaf piles or close to other vehicles during your collection week. This way, collection trucks can get to your leaf piles. Don't dump leaves, grass clippings, or other yard waste into storm drains along stream banks or directly into streams. Do use biodegradable paper lawn bags or 32-gallon trash cans. Leaves can clog storm drains or cause blockages that can contribute to localized flooding, among other things. Don't collect leaves in plastic garbage bags. And to get more information and look at the Leaf Collection Interactive Map, head to rockvillemd.gov/leafcollection. Still to come on Rock 11 Now, Rockville City Police make sure hundreds of kids get to school safely for Walk to School Day. We'll show you. And it's a night to celebrate Rockville's diversity, and it's going to be bigger and better this year. We'll tell you about this year's International Night right after this.
I think it's wonderful seeing how much food comes into this drive. I think it's also sobering to see how many people need help.
Until there is no one needing help, you have to continue to give of yourself.
It's the looks on their faces that it just really sets it in, like make it more real, and it's very heartwarming. It's really exciting.
You're able to provide the kids gifts to kind of normalize that one day. I think that really makes all the effort that my staff go through on a yearly basis worth it.
Rockville's premier source for news and information is now online. RockvilleReports.com is your online source for all the latest happenings in the city. From videos, pictures, even links to the city's website. RockvilleReports.com, your digital source for all things Rockville. Welcome back to Rock 11 Now. Local first graders paid a visit to City Hall. Rockville City police officers helped kids walk to school and even had conversation and coffee with some local residents. Look at some of the events that happened around your city last month.
A walk to school day, I think, is a great opportunity for kids and parents to know that there's alternative methods to transportation.
The students were so excited when they got off the buses. It was fun to see.
Just glad that today was a nice sunny day and the kids had a lot of fun, and it was awesome.
So this is a positive light for the kids and for the officers to see the kids in the community.
Really nice to see the city come out and support us, and everybody did a great job.
First grade students from Bell Elementary School here in Rockville took a field trip recently to City Hall. There they got a chance to see firsthand the way city government works and even snapped a few pics with the RCPD. Mayor Newton and Councilmember Pershala were on hand as well to talk about what they do and answer questions. And everybody left with a gift and a better understanding of how the city works for citizens of all ages. Here's to your future, Rockville. Great job. The 1940 mural of Sugarloaf Mountain by Judson Smith that greets visitors at the Rockville City Police headquarters looks almost like new after a recent conservation project by Hartman Fine Art Conservation Services. Check this out.
In this case, this is a painting that is painted on canvas that is glued to the wall. This painting was painted in 1938, and it's oil paint on canvas. And this was produced as a WPA mural. The federal government paid for this because this was a federal government building. And in this case, the major problems with the piece was that it had a lot of soot on the surface. The air handlers up top were spitting out black soot. It might have been coal dust, might have been coal or exhaust coming in through the windows. We've cleaned the painting, and we have varnished the painting, and then there were some losses. There were some nail holes through the painting, there were some scratches. So we have to match those colors exactly. And we have to match the sheen, we have to match the texture. We have cleaned this with tiny little Q-tips and swabs with chemicals, and in this case, detergents, because it was primarily dirt. We don't necessarily want the artwork to look like the day it came out of the artist's studio, because maybe a frame has aged, its finish has aged, just like bronze sculptures, that some of them are turning green. Well, that's supposed to be there. It's not a corrosion product that should come off. So it shouldn't look like the day that the artist necessarily put it out. It's, you know, 100 years old. We're not making the painting look any better than the frame. They all should look like they belong together, and that they've been hanging on your grandmother's wall for the past 75 years and not in your grandmother's barn. So in this case, fortunately, nobody had cleaned it. There was only a little bit of paint spatter on it. So we are the first ones to work on it, and it is a beautiful mural. It really is.
Up next, we're going to share some sights and sounds from this year's World of Montgomery Festival. So stay with us. Welcome back to Rock 11 Now. The 8th annual World of Montgomery Festival was a huge success. Rockville joined in with other DC metro area cities to celebrate international diversity with food, dance, music, and art. Take a look.
You know, Rockville is so proud to have such a great multicultural community too. So we just joined in the celebration and the festivity today as part of this huge melting pot that is Rockville.
Rockville and Montgomery County are incredibly diverse places. We treasure that diversity, and this is a great opportunity just to showcase the heritage of so many of our residents.
This year's International Night, being held Friday, November 18th, is going to be bigger and better with more performances, food, and cultural celebrations.
Rockville is a great place to live, and it represents so many different countries and cultures. So as it grows, we decided, why not keep having an International Night that represents Rockville's growth?
Rockville's International Night is an example of how the mayor and council are fulfilling one of its top priorities, supporting diversity. And this year, it's in a bigger venue.
Lincoln Park Community Center has been hosting International Night for 4 years, and it has outgrown the community center. So the staff of the community centers, we all got together, and we decided, why not have it here at the F. Scott Fitzgerald Theater? So this year, we decided to go bigger.
And bigger means the whole family can come out and enjoy the festivities for free.
This event is for anyone, so we're looking forward to having groups of all ages and families come out to see the different performances that represent Rockville. So there's two ways people can get their free tickets. They can go to Eventbrite and search City of Rockville, or they can go to rockvillemd.gov, search International Night, and get their tickets that way.
And we're taking a look at what's ahead for Rock 11 Now's upcoming Antique and Classic Car Show special, right after this message. It's time for Rockville Roll Call. And this month, we're going on patrol with the Rockville City Police Department to talk about their community policing initiative.
We have a really good working relationship with the citizens. They feel comfortable speaking with us. We feel comfortable engaging with them as well. And I think that it's mutually beneficial in keeping things safer for everybody overall. Well, not that long ago, during these peak hot days of summer, Chief Rappaport had an event called Cops with Pops. We showed up to that. We handed out popsicles to some of the kids over at the rec centers. I think that was pretty successful. It gave us the opportunity to just engage with the community, to engage with the younger people in our community, which is good because it makes us familiar faces. It helps make us more, helps make people more comfortable with us. It's just our day-to-day interactions in general. The Rockville City Police Department holds itself at a very high standard, so the officers that we have here are all kind of adhered to that high standard. You know, it doesn't matter what kind of call we go out to. It doesn't matter if it's an accident. It doesn't matter if it's some kind of theft call from one of the businesses here in Rockville, or if we have to go to somebody's home. Everybody here likes to do the best that they can when engaging with people. We're all very respectful, and we like to make sure that our job is done with a very good degree of professionalism.
It's known to be a city with a small town feel. And with that being said, you do have an opportunity to run into a lot of the same people, interact with them, get to gain a relationship, rapport with everyone that you come across to. It's just great because I really enjoy being able to interact with the community on a regular basis. You always see law enforcement officers out there engaging with the community as well, doing pretty much every event that we run. One of the most consistent comments that I receive on a regular basis is that we always treat everybody with respect, and that you know, they really enjoy the service of Rockville City Police officers.
We're able to hear the issues and the concerns of the community, be able to answer their questions. And I think being engaged like that allows them to build that trust that they know someone in the police department. They know they can come to the police department and ask a question or raise a concern. When we need the community's help, they're willing to help us because they trust us.
And finally, the 55th Annual Antique and Classic Car Show brought car lovers from across the area to the grounds of the Civic Center Park. And once again, Rocky Levin's resident self-proclaimed car enthusiast, Haga Balechian, will bring you some of the great car stories from this year's show. That's going to do it for this November edition of Rocky Levin Now. Keep up on the latest news and happenings in Rockville. Be sure to check out our online newsletter at rockvillereports.com. And join the Rockville conversation and check out our posts by signing up for Nextdoor at nextdoor.com. And to keep up with Rocky Levin, just subscribe to our YouTube channel at the City of Rockville. Follow us on Twitter at Rockville11, on Instagram at RockvilleMD, and like us on Facebook. For the entire Rocky Levin Now team, I'm Kathy Dantzler. Until next time, Rockville.